Funding provided by Musco Lighting, the sports lighting specialist, providing lighting systems for you, your project, and your community.
The Pella Rolscreen Foundation is a proud supporter of Iowa PBS. Pella Windows and Doors strives to better our communities and build a better tomorrow.
And by Fareway Meat and Grocery. For more than 80 years, Fareway has been proud to be an active part of the communities we serve. Learn more at fareway.com.
With our Iowa roots and Midwestern values, Farmers Mutual Hale is committed to offering innovative farm insurance for America's farmers, just as we have for six generations. Farmers Mutual Hale, America's crop insurance company.
Sun has set, but one more championship trophy needs to be handed out from Extreme Arena in downtown Coralville. You have it tuned in to Iowa High School Volleyball Championships, and it's the Class 1A Championship due up next. Holy Trinity Catholic, the Crusaders, the number 3 seed overall, no stranger to this postseason tournament, taking on Ankeny Christian Eagles, 38-3 overall, the number 1 overall seed. We hope you're having a wonderful day. We started at 10 a.m., and it's been a fun one. And this place has been hopping, and a lot of great volleyball has been witnessed here inside this building here in 2023.
Four great matches already. We are down to the final match of the day, but it's not quiet, it's not tired in here. This place is still electric, a lot of energy and excitement for the final match, the 1A state championship next.
Let's introduce you to the two teams that will be battling it out here. And Holy Trinity Catholic, it is their 16th trip to state. They've been here 13 of the last 14 years. And senior Mary Kate Benlagi, she's a good one, a Mount Mercy recruit, over 1,000 career digs and kills. Anna Benlagi also has 1,000 plus career assists. Don't forget about the underclassman sophomore Presley Myers, leading the team with 3 kills per set, averaging a 1A best 1.1 block per set for Holy Trinity Catholic. And their opponent, Ankeny Christian, second trip to state. They won this last year. We'll talk about dramatic fashion, how they did that. 6 starters return. Their nucleus is there, featuring a talented junior class. Caton Quick, a Drake commit, leads all classes in service aces with an eye-popping, staggering number.
149 aces this season so far. That is incredible. Great job from Katie Quick from the service line.
All right, we'll go to public address announcer Jason Esslinger with more on tonight's ceremonies.
High School Athletic Union has honored the state's greatest prep volleyball players with induction into the Iowa High School Volleyball Hall of Fame. Tonight we honor the 25th class of inductees. Presenting Hall of Fame awards is the executive director of the IGHSAU, Gene Berger. Today's first honoree is the second generation of stars from the great Dyke Bobcat teams coached by Barb Baker in the 1980s. Her mother was a member of the first Dyke team that won a championship in 1985. That legacy carried on to the next generation of stars that won 4 state championships for Coach Diane Harms and Dyke New Hartford in 2011 through 2014. She was a 4-time first team elite All-State selection, joining fellow Hall of Famer Haley Eckerman of Waterloo East as the only Iowa preps to earn elite All-State status all 4 years of high school. She helped the Wolverines to a 176-6 record during her 4 seasons. She was a member of 4 all-tournament teams, the captain of 3 of those squads, and was named the Class 2A Player of the Year 3 times. She averaged over 4 kills per set for her high school career. She went on to play 3 seasons for Hall of Famer and Dyke native Bobby Becker Peterson at Northern Iowa. She was a 2-time first-team All-Missouri Valley Conference performer and averaged over 3 kills and 3.5 digs in 3 seasons while helping the Panthers reach 3 NCAA tournaments. She went on to graduate from Allen College of Nursing and works at Waterloo's Allen Hospital as a neonatal ICU nurse. She lives in the Waterloo-Cedar Falls area and helps coach the 16-year-old division of the six-pack club volleyball team. Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome the fourth Dyke New Hartford player into the IGHSAU Volleyball Hall of Fame. Congratulations to Brianna Weber. Our next honoree started Harlan High School from 2011 through 2014. A four-time first-team All-State selection, she led the Cyclones to four state tournament appearances. She was the Class 4A Player of the Year in 2013 and 2014, averaging over five kills, one block, and two digs a set. She powered Harlan to 4A state titles in 2013 and 2014, and was the captain of both all-tournament teams. In those state tournaments, she averaged over seven kills and three digs per set. An outstanding basketball player, she led Harlan to two state championships in that sport and was a member of two all-tournament teams. After 4 years as a Harlan Cyclone, she became an Iowa State Cyclone in 2015. She was a four-year starter at Iowa State and is one of the most decorated players in Cyclone history. She was a three-time All-Big 12 first-team all-conference performer and was an honorable mention All-American three times. She is one of three Cyclones to finish their careers with 1,500 career kills and 1,000 digs. She was the first Iowa State player to record 300 or more kills in four separate seasons. After graduating from Iowa State, she went on to play beach volleyball for LSU for two seasons while pursuing her master's degree. She currently coaches the Blair High School volleyball team in Blair, Nebraska, and is a director at the River City Beach Volleyball Club. She and her husband, Will, are the parents to a 10-month-old son, Jace. Let's welcome the first Harlan Cyclone into the IGHSAU Volleyball Hall of Fame. Congratulations to Jess Shaban Lanceman. Our final inductee was a generational talent. She had all the tools, quickness, smarts, height, and above everything else, power. A four-year All-State selection at Holy Trinity Catholic, she led the Crusaders to four state tournament berths, winning a 1A state championship as a senior, and was named to three all-tournament teams, and was captain of two. She was an elite All-State performer three times, and was the state's overall Player of the Year in 2013 and 2014. For her career, she averaged an amazing 7.5 kills per set. She finished with 2,677 career kills, the most of any in the rally scoring era in Iowa. As one of the most sought-after volleyball recruits in the state's history, she signed with perennial powerhouse Nebraska and made an immediate impact. She helped Nebraska to four trips to the NCAA Final Four and won two national championships. She was named the most outstanding player of the Final Four in both national championship seasons. As a senior, she averaged 3.9 kills, was named first team All-American, and was named to the all-tournament team as the Cornhuskers finished second in the national tournament. When her career concluded, she collected 1,687 career kills, which ranks third in Nebraska history, while the Cornhuskers had a 21-2 record in the NCAA tournament, the best record of any Nebraska volleyball player. Following her Nebraska career, she played for Team USA and professionally in Italy. She returned to her hometown in West Point, Iowa, where she lives with her husband, Isaac Richter, and their daughter, Adeline. She is an assistant coach for the Holy Trinity volleyball team and works for Excel Sports. Ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome her back to the Girls State Volleyball Tournament one more time. Congratulations to Michaela Becky Richter. Ladies and gentlemen, let's meet the IGHSAU Volleyball Hall of Fame Class of 2023. From Dyke, New Hartford, Brianna Weber. From Harlan, Jess Shaban. And from Holy Trinity Catholic, Michaela Becky. Congratulations.
Congratulations to members of the 2023 Iowa High School Volleyball Hall of Fame. Here's a look at the road to state and to the championship match. As we get set, they turn off the lights, and we're about ready to welcome the teams to the court. Ankeny Christian defeated Newell Fonda and BCLUW. St. Ansgar also in that region. And then Holy Trinity Catholic took care of Don Bosco and Boyden Hull, as Council Bluffs St. Albert also in their region, as the road to state has been an interesting one between these two. As you take a look inside the Players Lounge right now, this is new this year. The Players Lounge, an off-court spot for athletes to chill out, keep an eye on current matches and unwind between games, maybe challenge a friend and tabletop cornhole, sit on the throne, be the queen of the court, do some dancing. A lot of fun activities here, and really their goal is student athlete first.
It's a fantastic experience. The Iowa Girls Union does it at the highest level. They want this to be special, and it is.
Let's welcome the two teams who are going to contend for the Class 1A championship title right now. Is being sent, second year of being played here at Extreme Arena in Coralville.
It's time to meet our teams. First, please welcome to the floor the Holy Trinity Catholic Crusaders.
And now, please welcome the Ankeny Christian Eagles.
Christian ranked number one in the state, Holy Trinity number three, as we will introduce now the non-starters and starters for both teams.
The players and coaches in tonight's championship matchup. First, for the Holy Trinity Catholic Crusaders, non-starters and assistant coaches first. A freshman, number five, Eva Denning. A freshman, number six, Elizabeth Griffin. A senior, number seven, Jenna Hellman. A freshman, number 12, Brooklyn Todd. A senior, number 14, Reagan Holvet. A sophomore, number 15, Emma Morfeld. A freshman, number 18, Ellie Hellman. A freshman, number 20, Megan Holtkamp. And the assistant coaches, Tom Gendron, Jordan Nelson, Michaela Richter, Stephanie Morfeld, and Jenna Friesmeyer. Now let's meet the starters for the Crusaders. A freshman, number three, Adeline Cruzy. A senior, number 11, Natalie Randolph. A senior, number 13, Mary Kate Benlagi. A senior, number 16, Tegan Denning. A sophomore, number 17, Presley Myers. A junior, number 24, Anna Benlagi. And the libero for the Crusaders, a junior, number one, Tegan Snod. Head coach for Holy Trinity Catholic is Melissa Friesmeyer. Now let's meet the Eagles. A senior, number three, Piper Ansel. A sophomore, number four, Ella Bussell. A sophomore, number 9, Ella Lever. A sophomore, number 10, Adeline Davenport. A freshman, number 11, Caitlin Weathers. A senior, number 18, Ava Erbel. The assistant coaches for the Eagles, John Gergen and Markel Studeman. Now let's meet the starters. A junior, number 1, Carly Craighead. A junior, number 2, Katie Quick. A junior, number 5, Macy Nearing. A junior, number 6, Morgan Fincham. A senior, number 15, Chloe Rowe. A junior, number 21, Anna Weathers. And the libero, a senior, number 12, Reese Journey. Head coach for Ankeny Christian, Michelle Quick. Now, ladies and gentlemen, for the introduction of our officials for tonight's match. First referee, Chris Rintz. Second referee, Casey Hoppe. And the line judges, Ted Mosier and Vince Workman.
Great officiating crew there. Well, a mainstay during the girls' state tournament. It's t-shirt maker Joe Leonetti, who says Extreme Arena and the Iowa High School Athletic Union have partnered to make it a very memorable experience for fans and players. Watching him do his thing, making lots of awesome souvenirs to take home for fans of all ages. And you see directly behind the court, that's where Dyke New Hartford is currently taking pictures and celebrating the fact that they are the Class 2A state champions. Really doing it right here, as every year the union continues to add more and more to make this a positive experience. Let's take a look now at the keys to the match. Beth West, Eric Braley on the call here. Beth, former D1 volleyball player, standout. What do you think Holy Trinity needs to do to secure the 1A state title?
For Holy Trinity Catholic to be successful tonight, we are looking for their front row to be active with a strong net presence. This means controlling any overpasses and putting up a solid block, just like they've done this week at state, where they've outblocked their opponents in the first two matches. And secondly, they want to enjoy the championship atmosphere and battle together as a team with confidence.
That's the keys for Holy Trinity. How about Ankeny Christian?
For Ankeny Christian, they returned 6 starters from last year's state championship team, so they have great experience to carry into this final championship match of the day. They're a tough serving team who is looking to execute their strategy so that they can bring home back-to-back state volleyball titles to their school.
The keys, the starters, the Hall of Fame, the stage is set, the bright lights are on, and it's down to this. Folks, this is the final volleyball match of the 2023 Iowa High School volleyball season. Who's it gonna be that joins Waukee Northwest, North Scott, Western Christian, and Dyke New Hartford as champions here today? It will be a little confusing watching at home, as both teams have nearly identical uniforms. We'll try and help you with that. A little easier if one is green and one is red, but getting the first point here is Ankeny Christian. Again, leads all classes in service aces, averaging near over 3.5 per set. So, pretty good start for Ankeny Christian.
Wanting to start with their best server, like you said, Katie Quick, 149 aces on the year, hoping to add to that tally tonight in this championship match.
Adding, she is. And starting to get a little separation early on here. It all starts with the serve received. The setter cannot set, the hitters cannot hit, unless you get a good pass. That's a good one, and look what happens. First points for Holy Trinity.
Quality passing is the foundation of everything in volleyball. Holy Trinity in system with that quality pass. They run their middle quick. It's a great swing.
The setter serving it up. Near side tip, and it's down for the point. Really did a nice job disguising that she was just gonna tip it over the block and not try and hammer it through.
Denning on the outside, her normal approach, you're right, and then at the last second, tipping it just over the top of the block. Good vision to see an opening on the floor.
Down the line, it goes out of bounds. An attack air, a 3-0 run to start, and a 3-0 run to answer. Crusaders with Randolph serving the senior.
A quick set behind for Ankeny Christian. Having multiple hitters as an option, choosing to go behind and catching the defense off guard when it's a fast-paced, low-tempo swing like that.
Need to send it over on this ball, and they do. Here's the set. No, it's not. Fooled everybody. Little campfire defense, and the court was wide open for that setter's dump.
Setters tend to have great vision. They know the defense well. And if they see an opening, sometimes they call their own number. I like it. Be aggressive, tipped it right over, helping continue this run for Holy Trinity Catholic.
Randolph had 181 kills on the year to go with her 446 assists. Great atmosphere is Class 1A championship taking place here. And the swing goes down for the point. Here's another look at it.
High set. Craighead for Ankeny Christian times it well with her approach so that she can get a high contact point there, wanting to go cross court around that block. The Eagles wanting Craighead to be efficient. She's going to get a lot of sets tonight. She does a good job for Ankeny Christian.
One arm save, longest rally that we've seen here in this young first set. And Ankeny Christian with the point to pull ahead here by two. Look at the replay. As that double block was there, went straight off the hands of Myers, the sophomore. Oh, momentum. And Ankeny Christian starting to heat up a little bit.
Putting up a solid block, shutting down that line, pressing over, making sure that it doesn't trickle through.
Good pass, looking for the side out. Free ball back to their side of the net. Great back row defense. Just mishit that one. Is trying to cut it near the front of the net was Carly Craighead. The side out in the rotation. Libero coming out into the back row. Here's Presley Myers. Myers leading the team in kills. Great idea to go with that cross-court swing.
Cross-court and deep, very deep. And Ankeny Christian, not quite sure, should we have touched it, should we not? Sometimes when you're unsure, you just stick an arm out. Maybe that time, though, unable to control it on their side.
And the side out, that's the thing in volleyball. You have to make split-second decisions all the time.
It's a fast-paced game, and it's a game of runs. We've seen that so far in set one with runs from both sides already.
Anna Weathers, a strong play. Ankeny Christian leading by two. Setter's dump. All over it defensively. And then a hit out of bounds. Good defensive play at the front row there.
Staying home as the middle blocker for the Crusaders. Seeing that Ankeny Christian wanted to take it over on two. Identifies it, goes up, blocks strong. Ankeny Christian tried to cover, but unable to control it.
Then Loggy the serve. Great job to keep from scooting underneath the net. That would have been a violation. Attacking the block and getting the point.
Anna Withers not afraid to swing away, going right through the hands of the blockers.
A real special talent. And answering with the kill and the point. Well, Beth, it really feels like in the early going, they're kind of feeling each other out, getting comfortable, getting set. But neither team allowing their opponent to go on a run here. The largest run we've seen is 3 points in a row.
Sticking to their original strategy, especially in these opening points in set one. And then if they need to adjust and change something, maybe switch a matchup, rotate differently, they'll do that in the future. But you're right, still figuring it out, still calming down, getting into a rhythm.
Ankeny Christian first to double digits here, but then an errant serve. Hey, that happens from time to time. That'll give the ball back here to Holy Trinity Catholic. Well, last year I mentioned winning, but in dramatic fashion, in the fact that you have to win three sets. And sometimes you win in a 3-0 sweep like Dyke New Hartford just did. Sometimes you win in four, like Western Christian did. But sometimes you have to get a sweep, you have to do a reverse sweep.
Exactly, Ankeny Christian last year in the 1A championship goes down 0-2, backs against the wall. They don't panic. Next three sets, they win them all. Reverse sweep, just like you called it, to win in five. Very exciting.
It doesn't happen that often. It's so hard to do after dropping the first two, but it does happen, and it's thrilling when it does. Now to a dozen, leading by three here in the opening set. The serve, aggressive, but sails out of bounds. And the Crusaders get the point. Natalie Randolph, the senior, 181 kills, 58 aces, and 446 assists. Able to knock that one down. The Eagles.
It just sneaks through the blockers, rolled on the top of the tape. Not quite sure how it got through, but it did, and it's down for a kill. With a fantastic ace.
Mary, the junior outside hitter. She has 106 aces. Don't know how many teams in the history of Iowa High School volleyball have three players with 100 aces or more in the regular season. Clearly, that's one of their things they hang their hat on and take pride in. Coaches talking it over. Strategy of where to serve, what zone, and then calling it out as Denning serves it up. Not a good pass. Back row roll shot. And got that thing to get through. Wasn't the hardest hit ball.
Good effort from Presley Myers on the Holy Trinity Catholic side. She went up, got that block touch, tried to come down and pop it up. Got called for a lift, but I do appreciate the effort. Good turn there as a middle blocker. You're constantly blocking, turning, and being as fast as you can to find where's the ball, where do I need to transition, what's next?
Middle hitters, middle blockers, your head is on a swivel, and you're moving laterally sideline to sideline as quickly as possible. Well, both teams have two timeouts. No one has used one yet. But Ankeny Christian feel like if they score one or two more points, might need to call one here. Big point inside out in the rotation. And coming in is number three, Adeline Cruzy, the freshman. Setter's dump. Trying to work that middle. The approach is good, but an even better up in the back row by the libero.
Hey, side out! Side out!
Tip down to the court.
As a front row, if you're gonna go up and put up a double block, that's great. But coaches will always remind you, if you're not gonna go up and block, be an active off blocker so you can help your teammates and pick up those tips.
Well, I was thinking that Holy Trinity might call a timeout, and now they've rattled off two straight points. And the attack. We play on. The crowd eating this up here. The hustle on both sides of the net, and then an easy one like that just drops in. You battle, you battle, you battle. And then a smart heads-up decision to get the point pull within one.
Sometimes a change of speed is all that it takes. That roll shot perfectly placed in the middle of the court.
Off the hands and out of bounds. 16-14. And the rotation, as you see the student section decked out in white. Craighead, the junior, serving it up. But no run for Ankeny Christian. A side out and a chance to serve now. Here's the replay as Anna Benlagi gets set to serve from our net cam. Such a tight opening set between these two programs. Joust, and winning the joust. It took a couple cracks at it, but winning it and earning that point.
Ankeny Christian with their setter, Katie Quick, going up. She's the smaller of the two players, you can see that. But joust, when it's a 50-50 ball at the net, it's all about timing. A little bit of power, but a lot of timing. And so being able to be the second player who contacts and pushes it through as that first player is kind of coming down.
Smart to let that ball sail out of bounds. Holy Trinity Catholic, they're playing good, but gonna call their first timeout here as they trail by three here in the opening set. Let's listen in with Melissa Friesmeier.
Okay, read a little quicker. We stay aggressive, all right? And let's keep targeting, stay away from the libero. All right, when we're serving, so if I'm giving you a 5-6, go to the seam, but go towards the other player, okay? Go to the blue, not the white. Hey, doing a good job. Keep going after it, all right? We got it? All right, here we go.
Oh!
Let's go, we got this.
Coach calling out different locations on the volleyball court. So the court is broken up into six different zones. So she's saying, hey, let's serve the seam between the five and the six area on the court, which is gonna be in the back part. And she's saying, if the libero is in one of those, go to the other side. So good strategy there. And again, pointing out, hey, let's serve tough and then back it up with some defense. Right here, they need to get a quality pass so they can side out.
So the Eagles have the ball. 18-15 our score. Great electric atmosphere in the fifth and final match of the day. You're enjoying it here, broadcasting on Iowa PBS. Another good attack. good distribution as multiple players getting involved. Balanced attack. Nearing with five kills, four for Craighead. Makes it 19-16. Side out and back to serve for the libero. And such a strong player is Reese. Just that laser focus. Here's the serve. And it's long. Trying to do everything she can to help her team, but just went deep on that aggressive serve. Adeline Cruzy, she's just a freshman. She played in 102 sets out of 102 sets. You know you gotta be good if you're starting varsity as a freshman on a state championship contending team.
Having an impact right away in her first year and playing in every single set, great experience to carry forward as a leader into the future. But she's not ready to think about that yet. She's got business to do tonight.
Into the net, denied. And playing some really good volleyball here is Ankeny Christian. The Eagles starting to get a bit of separation. Katie Quick, the junior setter. Free ball back to the Eagles side of the net. Down to the court for the point. And electing to use her second and final timeout is Holy Trinity Catholic's head coach, Melissa Friesmeyer. Here's a look at that last play as we listen in to Ankeny Christian's huddle and Michelle Quick.
Court is wide open. Let's keep getting those passes right into Katie's hands. We put those passes into Katie's hands and we can run a faster pace. So keep that pace going and then drive that ball down. If we have to drive a quick one over the top, do that. But right now, let's finish it. Let's finish this game, okay? Yeah. When you guys see that from the back row, what they're doing with their hands, you got to scream it out loud so the people in front of you know what's going on, okay? Yeah. Scream it out loud. Whatever we need to do, say it out loud, even louder, so that everybody can hear what's going on as far as the tips. Keep driving that ball down hard. Keep them guessing. No, keep them guessing. Put them in Katie's hands. Put them in Katie's hands.
Eyes up.
Great advice from the head coach, Michelle Quick. Fifth year of coaching, all 5 years coming at Ankeny Christian. 140 wins to just 40 losses. And second state tournament appearance. Student section getting into things here as we near the end of this opening set. Another long rally between these two squads. Off the hands of the block, one-handed save. We play on. And the setter dump again, disguised perfectly and executed.
Good defense on both sides. The headers were swinging hard. That defense was dug in. Katie Quick for Ankeny Christian recognizes that Holy Trinity was on their heels, so she sends it over on two. Always a heads-up play from a setter when they can recognize and see the opening on the opponent's side.
All right, 23-18. Inside that timeout, she talked about pace. Why is that important in the sport of volleyball?
Head coach Michelle Quick talked about if we can get a good pass, let's speed up our offense. Right here we saw it, a real lower set, real quick, trying to, again, make your blockers move faster, make that defense move faster to try to keep up with you, hoping to catch them off guard. It's easier to do when you have a good pass. Tougher to do when the pass is off the net or if you're scrambling. So that's why Coach Quick was really emphasizing, hey, let's get it in Katie's hands. Put it in Katie's hands, saying, get it right to your setter.
Look at that effort. Effort pays off.
Great chase down, not giving up, pursuing that ball off the court. And then it turns into a swing long from Ankeny Christian. Good shot from the Crusaders, staying with it.
Nice pass, the attack, the block was there, a hitting air, and you might see a timeout coming soon as the momentum has shifted in favor of Holy Trinity. Love the fact they have not given up, even though they're down. And now they're applying pressure, to say the least. Eagles get it blocked. Gonna try it again on the outside. That time it gets through off the hands, last touch. And that brings up set point in favor of Ankeny Christian. Again, such a balanced front line.
Craig heading there using the hands of the blockers. But you're right, there's multiple players that Ankeny Christian can dish out the set to.
Set point. Gonna be close to the net. Reaching over, the joust is down. Carly Craighead reaches over and gets the point. An entertaining opening set. And it's Ankeny Christian winning it. Your defending champion is one step closer to winning the 2023 1A championship. But we're just getting started. Back with more. You haven't tuned in to the Iowa High School Volleyball Championships here on Iowa PBS.
You're watching live coverage of the Girls State Volleyball Championships on Iowa PBS. Stay tuned. More to come.
I remember pulling my headgear away from my head because it was so loud in Hilton of people cheering against you.
Crowd is on its feet at Hilton Coliseum.
This was probably one of the greatest teams of all times.
Iowa has won 36 straight dual meets.
And one of the greatest duels of all times.
Iowa State, it's one of the best shows on earth.
Coming to Iowa PBS November 20th.
Join Iowa PBS as we explore the arts and the architecture within the historic buildings of Iowa, Mason City, and Clear Lake.
Coming to Iowa PBS November 18th.
The thing about Native women leaders, they have that toughness, that backbone.
I will continue to fight for our most vulnerable people. There's always work to be done.
I'm proud to say that I am a Native designer. I embrace that.
As a woman, it's a part of my responsibility to take care of the environment. We owe her our life.
Tuesday evening at 8 on Iowa PBS.
There's even more to love about Iowa PBS Online. Find interesting stories and connect with fellow Iowans when you follow Iowa PBS on Facebook. Connect with us on all of our social media platforms at iowapbs.org/social.
You're watching statewide Iowa PBS.
An entertaining opening set saw Ankeny Christian pulling away just at the very end to win 25-21. Take a look at some of the many highlights as some outstanding play across the board here. What was your main takeaway from that opening set, Beth?
We knew Ankeny Christian was good at serving. They brought aggressive serves. I think Holy Trinity was able to settle in and adjust to that. They picked it up late, had a late push. Ankeny Christian able to sustain it, winning late in the set. But I think Holy Trinity is settling into a rhythm here in set two. They'll be able to bring that aggressiveness.
They won the last 5 minutes of this match, it felt like, as you see the stats on your screen and just how balanced this was. Both teams wearing blue. Ankeny Christian, they are wearing the short sleeve V-neck. And Holy Trinity Catholic, they're in the long sleeve blue on your screen. That ball's in. Again, it's hard to cover every square inch of the court, so you have to kind of decide what you do and what you give up, and good job taking advantage of that placement.
As a team, you talk about blocking responsibilities, and if you're going to take certain angles away, and then your backcourt defense and off blockers are able to defend around that. But you want to make sure everyone's on the same page, right? That they know what the assignments are and then working around it.
Presley Myers, she's a special sophomore. 309 kills. Now Natalie Randolph, the senior, with the serve. Sometimes you see those setters, not the best pass. All they can do is kind of put one hand on it just to guide that ball to where one of their hitters is located. You see it again on that play. The block earns a point.
Putting up a double block. The power off of that swing, off the blocker's arms, goes deep. Ankeny Christian, their coverage, they were all sucked in close, which is normally where the ball comes off of a block, that time going deep for the block point.
A whistle, and that's going to go against Holy Trinity Catholic. Okay, so the Crusaders get the point, and it's now 3-1 with the serve. Randolph again, deep, and just a little too much on that one. Good communication in that back row as head coach looks on as Michelle Quick, based out of Polk County, the Bluegrass Conference, have had a tremendous year. Only losses coming versus Grundy Center. They made it all the way to the Class 3A semifinals. There's a point, and we're tied at 3 here in the second set.
Craighead with the tip right over the top of the blockers. The back row defender on that line deep, unable to make a move, a run through on that very short, shallow tip.
Good adjustment to tip that ball over the net.
Side out!
Into the net, and the attack there by Anna Benlagi. A lot of the sport of volleyball is trying to take away things and make it as challenging as possible for your opponent. Some scouting has been done here, obviously, but then it's going out and executing the strategy.
And hitters tend to have shots that are their favorites, right? Whether it's a hard cross court or they really like to tip line. And the good hitters are able to adjust with what the set and the block gives them. They have so many different, what we call tools in their tool bag, right, to mix it up. And so even though I might love to go hard cross court, if the block is taking that away, I need to be smart, see that, recognize it, and go line. So we'll look for that as players adjust as well. Like you said, it's a strategy game, right? What can we take away? What can we give?
Service ace makes it 6-4. Ankeny Christian, again, last year's 1A state volleyball champion. Coach Sangs, start fast and say you can. That T on the end of it doesn't count.
No.
You can't do something. You can.
Say you can. That self-talk, building that confidence, visualizing a good play, visualizing a win. Say you can. I like that mantra.
But how much of an advantage is it that Holy Trinity has been here 13 of the last 14 years and that Ankeny Christian literally played and won this match last year?
There's something to say about just familiarity in an environment like this. to have that experience to know, yep, we're going to run out here and we're going to warm up in this way and the crowd is going to be loud during these points. Just being familiar with the environment goes so far. And both of these squads have that in recent years.
You can try and reciprocate it and make it feel like it is in your high school gymnasium. But once you get here under the bright lights, the extreme arena, and thousands of people packed in here, and you're playing arguably one of the toughest opponents you've faced all year. You want to be as prepared as possible. Currently a 3-point lead for Ankeny Christian here in the second set. And they get the point there.
Running that fast tempo offense that Coach Quick talked about, when they get those good passes, the middle is up as an option for Ankeny Christian. Good connection, she's able to power it away.
Smart decision as Holy Trinity finds a little gap in the defense.
Nobody home, right in the middle of the court, guarding that perimeter of the court, leaving right in the middle that donut wide open.
Anna Benlaghi with the serve. A little handoff on the set. Not perfect, but they did a great job. And now look at this hot pursuit. Holy Trinity trying to take advantage that they're in scramble mode for a little bit. 9-6, set to the middle, and a hard hit ball. Wow.
Credit to Holy Trinity Catholic just keeping that fire going, bringing their attack over and over, because Ankeny Christian was digging everything. They were chasing it down. They were pursuing every ball. But Holy Trinity, they kept swinging away. Good job.
Sometimes it's the first swing that gets the point, like right there. Other times it might be your fourth, fifth, or sixth attack, as we've seen some rallies between these two squads that have lasted close to a minute before we decide who gets the point. 10-7, and strong serving continues to be one of the difference makers in this one. Think about what you can do individually in certain sports. Like a pitcher can work on just pitching, free throws in basketball. But serving is one of the few things, and it's so important because it's the first thing that kicks off the entire play.
It sets the tone of the play, absolutely. And you can get reps on your own in the gym with no one else around serving. It's hard to do anything else. You can do some passing and some swings against the wall, and that's good. That's better than nothing. But serving, it's the exact same. You can visualize seams. You can hit zones. You can put out targets. You can practice it all on your own.
Practice, repetition, logging those hours in, and visualize being in this situation with a state title on the line for your school, for your community. Here's a look at that replay again. The block denying the attack. Holy Trinity trying to put a run together here. This time going to the middle. Great cut and finish. Adeline Cruzzi, the freshman, has 130 kills during the regular season, ranked third on the team as a freshman. Hard hit volleyballs in this 1A championship match. Little uncertainty, your ball or mine, and when you hit the ball right between two players, That split-second decision and communication is vitally important.
And that time, Ankeny Christian out of system, setting up their setter, but she's able to take a left-handed swing. So fun for Katie Quick to not just tip it or assist it to her teammate. She's able to swing away on the point before.
Tegan Snott has done a great job as the libero for Holy Trinity. She'll head to the bench in the rotation here. Again, love the effort. Kind of falls a little awkwardly. So do a quick double check to make she's sure she's okay. You see a slippage. And she is fine. She receives and gets a good pass right out of the gates. And then it's returned down the line for a kill. Nice play by Natalie Randolph, the senior.
First swing side out, a coach's dream. When you get a great serve receive pass, set it up, that first swing you get a kill. That's what we call a first swing side out. That's the dream, every time.
Ball pops high up into the air, and then it's kind of set over the net. Back row swing. They say it did not hit the court, so we play on. That time it did. You can't celebrate early in a championship match. Let's take a look. Was it a pancake? Did her hand slide underneath before the ball hit? Ball goes. Her hand most certainly slid underneath that. Popped it up. You can use any part of your body to keep the ball off the court. Violation. And now it's 15-12 as the Eagles go up by three. Well, Beth, you talked about things you can practice independently in the sport of volleyball, but club volleyball is definitely something. It's not just volleyball played from August till the end of October, first week of November. There's lots of other reps going on for a lot of student athletes across the state of Iowa.
Exactly. After the high school season, club volleyball starts. And it really goes through all winter, spring, some national tournaments in the summer as well. And you're able to play on club teams with girls from other schools. And so you're learning from different coaches, playing with different teammates, getting more reps, getting some high level competition, as most teams will travel outside of the state and go to large tournaments. There's different levels to it, just kind of like classes at the high school level. But a good opportunity if you're someone who loves the sport, wants to continue it after the school season. Club volleyball really gets you that exposure, those reps to continue to develop.
15-15 here. How much time you invest into it. And again, I like that, playing with different teammates, different coaching styles, but nothing can be better than winning a state title for your school with your classmates and best friends.
It does have a different atmosphere, a different feel to it, because you spend so much time with your high school team, right? You spend time in the classroom, different activities before and after school, practices for weeks on end, every single day, traveling. Whereas club, you might see each other a couple times a week, and you know, obviously the weekend tournaments, but it's a different feel for high school. There's a pride and a just different feel to want to bring home wins to your community. You're representing your whole town and community and school.
Some big celebrations after that block denied. Again, you cannot fault the effort on anyone who's playing here in this 1A championship match. Strong serve again, and we've seen that result happen time and time again. It's an ace and a timeout called on the court. We're in set two, and it's it's Ankeny Christian leading by three. Let's listen in to Holy Trinity's huddle.
I agree with that.
Right now, positive energy. Let's go.
Celebrate the huge
ball. We've had so many good points. Let's go.
All right, come on now. Let's go get them. Let's go. Let's go. Come on. Hey, we need everybody. Let's go.
Well, talk about an advantage from a coaching staff situation as head coach Melissa Friesmeier, 21st year at Holy Trinity Catholic, 32nd year overall, and has over 1,000 career victories, 21 state tournament appearances. Oh, and by the way, talking to her on the sideline, just inducted into the Hall of Fame here, former Holy Trinity standout Michaela Fecky, inducted. There you see her. Many would say she might be the best who ever did it in the state of Iowa.
A standout in high school for Holy Trinity. So many records and amazing victories during her time in high school. But then the story does not end. It gets so much better because she goes on to Nebraska, plays for John Cook, arguably one of the best coaches at the collegiate level still, and she has a fantastic career. 4 years, four Final Fours for Division I with two national championships, and in those two national championships, she's crowned the most outstanding player. I mean, it's just, you can't write it up any better. She's a fantastic athlete, really had a great career, and fun to see that she's back at her high school giving back, coaching these young student athletes.
Played USA volleyball and now moved back to her hometown, married and assisting, paying it forward to the next generation. 19-16, it's blocked, but it's blocked out of bounds. The last touch by Holy Trinity, tooling it out, and it's now a 4-point advantage for Ankeny Christian. Several college players will go on to play at the college level on both sides of the net here. Smart decision, and it's now a 5-point lead, and the second and final timeout being called by Holy Trinity. So let's listen to Michelle Quick, head coach of Ankeny Christian.
Absolutely. That's what we want to see, right? Everybody's doing exactly what they need to do. They're expecting you to come in hard, drop it right over the top, just like you know how to do, right? Take it in there, find that hole, and let's keep going, pressing forward. Stay on the perimeter and go hard. If you need to drop it in sneaky, drop it in sneaky. Do what you got to do, okay?
Let's go.
Okay, do it.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Eagles, eyes up.
I love how they end each huddle. Eagles, clap, clap, eyes up. And again, so much of it you think is power, but sneakiness is an actual thing, right, in sports.
I love that strategy. She's saying go in hard, but hey, if you need to, it's okay to be sneaky. Tip it right over the top. And you're right, it's all about placement, whether you're bringing that power or you're changing up the speed of your attack and being sneaky right over the top of the block.
Element of disguising the attack, trying to throw the opponent off. Ankeny Christian number one in the state, Holy Trinity number three. Ankeny Christian won set one. We're in the later stages of the second set here. We're in the long sleeve blue tops is Holy Trinity. The short sleeve and V-neck is Ankeny Christian. Smart decision, reaching over. Wasn't sure if the ball was gonna sail all the way over her side, just a little tap down. And now they pull within 3 points of moving up in the series, two sets to none. Let's go to our net camera. It's been working hard all day. And you see the play by Chloe Rowe, the senior, right side hitter. Over 50 kills this season. Momentum is definitely in favor of the Eagles right now, Beth.
The Eagles able to find seams between the Holy Trinity defenders. They're finding openings. You're right, riding this momentum, really stringing together quality play.
Needing a point and getting one right there as the Crusaders Again, balanced attack. Ben Loggi with 8 kills. A couple of players with 4 or 5. Setter sending it over on 2. What a play. Changing the trajectory of the ball. Wow. And 2 contact lift brings up set point. Let's look at this one again.
Reese for Ankeny Christian in that libero jersey. She is all over the court. Just touch it. Just get a touch. That's the mentality. Just keep it alive.
Set point for Ankeny Christian. Down for the point. Crusaders.
Turning that one down the line. Good vision. Keeping the hope alive for a little longer for the Crusaders here.
There it is, the final point of the second set. The final score is 25-18. Ankeny Christian, your defending 1A champion, is so close, but still work to be done. Back with more, this is Iowa PBS.
Your men need you.
Seems pretty conclusive.
I could make it worth your while.
He's got himself embroiled with a gangster.
Are you trying to get me killed?
I can't get back to how it was before.
We need you.
We hold the line at all costs.
This is the fight now.
You don't have to turn everything into an
investigation. There's always someone
watching. Sunday evening at 7 on Iowa PBS.
It's a war.
China is beating the United States in tech-heavy industries.
Over technology.
Everybody in the world is talking about 5G.
From healthcare, education, manufacturing, China got the message of what could 5G do.
But can they do it alone?
China is at least 5 to 15 years behind the U.S. in semiconductor technologies.
Inside China's Tech Boom on Nova.
Wednesday evening at 8 on Iowa PBS.
Sometimes in life you have those moments
in all its glory.
With singing, dancing, magicians.
Yeah! Here we go,
just what I wanted for Christmas.
We have much to be grateful for.
The platypus have been granted this window into their world.
Can you tell me the truth?
What do you remember?
You're watching Statewide Iowa PBS.
Ankeny Christian in the driver's seat, winning 25-21, 25-18. Eric Braley and Beth West sitting courtside here. So close, but yet, let's remember what happened last year.
Exactly. Ankeny Christian was down 0-2 last year. They came back and won 3 straight to take the title. So there is hope for Holy Trinity. I know that's in the mind of Ankeny Christian as well. They want no let up. They want to push all on the gas here. No breaks. They want to push, win in 3. But again, Holy Trinity, there's time. They got to make some changes, string together some points, come out strong here in set 3.
Here's a look at some of the highlights from that last set. Both sets have been extremely close, but give credit to Ankeny Christian playing with that championship mentality. They've had just enough in the tank to pull away and secure the victory. Let's see how much is left here as we're in the Class 1A championship match. Need to win 3 sets to claim the title. Crusaders getting the first point.
Number
Here's Randolph. A little misdirection with the back set. Holy Trinity sending it over. Outside over the block. Great defense in the back row there by Mary-Kate Benlaghi. Through the block, down for the point. She's not the tallest, but boy, does she have a heart of a champion, and she plays so tough.
Neri listed at 5'6", but she's not afraid of that double block. She's bringing power straight through their arms. I love it, heart of a champion. She's going after it, you're right.
Through the block and the point. Presley Myers, she's a tremendous sophomore, as Myers leads the Crusaders in kills with 3 per set, blocks with 1.1, and a lot of the team's success this year can be credited with her development over the course of the season. Ball sails out, and the Crusaders, I'm always impressed when it's a non-setter trying to get the ball to a hitter in a decent position.
Teams practice out of system balls like that where the setter is not taking that second ball. How can we better it? How can we still get an attack and not send over a free ball? So lots of drills in practice throughout the year in out of system scenarios. So they worked on it, but it doesn't make it any easier when it's actually in a pressure filled match like this. So good job to all the non-setters taking that second ball, making sure their hitters either on the left or the right or back row can get a swing.
Good shot from our net camera. And serving might be the difference maker between winning a state title and not. Behind the line, locked in, Morgan Finchman. Fincham. 56 aces on the season. Well off the net with that swing, but it does not matter. We have a 4-3 score here in this third set.
Mary-Kate adjusting her approach, still able to get a fast arm swing, some snap on that wrist to get the kill for the Crusaders.
Well, it was last year, Gladbrook Rhinebeck. We talked about it, up 2-0 when Ankeny Christian Eagles, not to be denied, claiming the next 3 sets to win their first state championship in any girls sport. As sophomore Macy Mehring had 18 kills for the championship match. Carly Craighead had 20. And Craighead and Quick were all tournament team selections. That was 1 year ago, the 2022 State Volleyball Championship in Class 1A. Guiding that ball over. And a big celebration for Ankeny Christian.
The names you just read off for Ankeny Christian last year, we mentioned it before, they all returned this year.
With that championship mentality. Hey, Beth, it's not easy to have that bullseye, that target on your back. I know you've done it at the Division I college level of being the reigning champ and having to go out and prove it again. Everyone's giving you your best night in and night out because there's nothing better than knocking off the champ. But they've held their heads high, they persevered, and they're getting close. With plays like what we've seen here tonight.
There's two ways to play with a chip on your shoulder, right? Kind of that underdog mentality, get after it, we've got nothing to lose, give it your best. And the chip on your shoulder of knowing, like you said, that there is a target on your back and that you can't have a let up, right? That you have to bring your best because you know the opponent is doing everything in their power to try to undermine your undefeated season or your really good record or whatever it might be.
But even in the offseason, strength and conditioning and different things, just staying disciplined and not putting it on cruise control and post mode.
Having goals, having motivation, having little milestones throughout either the off season or in regular seasons are so important to a team, to have something to look forward to, have something to work towards together as a team, accomplish it, check it off, and then move on to the next. What's the next goal we want to achieve?
It's always good to have a series of goals, so it's not just working for the very end of the year, but little milestones that you can check off your to-do list. Block was set up, but it wasn't completely sealed off. And it's now 8-6, early stages here. A look at the bench, seeming loose and confident here as this third set is really starting to take form. Big point there. Again, not getting a lot of swings real close to the net. They have to vary the angles and the placement with their balls.
Adjusting your approach, your footwork, and then also adjusting your arm swing, depending on, like you said, how close or how far away that set is, how low, how high it is. A lot of adjustments that you can make as a hitter to make sure you're getting a fantastic swing regardless of the set location or set height.
There's a look at the replay again. It's a give and go. You get a pass, you get it back with the set, and you finish it. In the net violation. So the point will go to the Crusaders. Yeah, Crusaders on the year, a number of losses, but teams that are either class 3A, 4A, or 5A, and a number of losses to teams that made it here to Coralville and the state tournament. I think, you know, those 5A teams always don't have the luxury of playing larger opponents, but the 1A and 2A, you see how team schedule that expect to be playing meaningful games in late October, early November. They don't care if they suffer a loss. They want to play the best so that they're battle-tested and ready to rock when it matters most and the stakes are high.
Learning what opportunities to grow and develop early in the season against those really tough opponents pays dividends when it's October and you get to regional play.
Just 3 points between Ankeny Christian and Holy Trinity, but we have our first timeout here of this third set. Let's listen in to Holy Trinity's huddle right now.
Can't get everything in one swing. Take what they give us and keep talking to each other, all right? Pick each other up. We got this? All right, we got this? Everybody ready? All right, let's go. Pick each other up. Let's go.
Trying to pick each other up. It's a team sport. As the student section has witnessed some great volleyball here in this 1A championship match. Well, the keys that you had coming in, let's revisit those, Beth, as we try and figure out what maybe these two teams have to do to finish strong.
For Holy Trinity Catholic, we talked about them needing a strong net presence and then battling with confidence. And as Coach said, pick each other up, help each other out, have that confidence. And then for Ankeny Christian, we've talked about it multiple times, leveraging the experience that they gained last year, having so many of those key starters and key players back in order for them to defend their title.
So out of the timeout, more times often than not, you see the team that calls the timeout gets that very next point. And that happens right here as Holy Trinity. Just a quick catch your breath, regroup, and go out there and execute. Denning to serve.
Running the middle, not immediately next to the setter, but in that three zone in between the pin and the setter. Fast tempo, lowering that set height down, catching Holy Trinity off guard, but a good connection, setter hitter there for Ankeny Christian to put it away.
One arm save, free ball. Love the effort. Off the block and down for the kill. And Ankeny Christian's rattling off a couple quick points here, leading by four.
One on one in the middle. Withers for Ankeny Christian, able to use the hands of the block. Just that one blocker up, tools it out of bounds.
Two contacts, she lifted the ball, which is a violation and a side out, and serve coming for number 17, Presley Myers.
Tough position to be in as a setter when the pass is low and you're in the back row playing defense. Yep. You gotta play defense first, hold your ground, but then to be quick enough to release and to get such a low pass there is very tough.
Trying to make the most out of not the best opportunity. Antenna's waving, it sails out of bounds, and we'll have a side out. So out of the front row will come Myers, and in will be the libero, Tegan Snow. Holy Trinity's team motto, all in. We talk about that team approach. Smart heads-up play. But here's the thing, you can't just trade points if you're the Crusaders.
Need to go on a run, starting with aggressive serves, backing it up with their defense. But you're right, they need to start now. We're getting into that midsection of the set. Volleyball, you break down a set to 25 into smaller batches, and now is go time.
Yes.
For Holy Trinity.
15 to 11 now. Talking with Ankeny Christian's team, and they filled out a survey before the championship match. Asked, so who are your team's super fans? Oh, for sure, all the grandparents. Don't miss a home match, and you better believe they're here watching right now. There's Ankeny Christian on the brink of winning back-to-back state titles. A lot of heat on that attack.
Support for these teams at state, starting on Monday in the quarterfinals till now, the championship on Thursday. Families, friends, school classmates, the community, they get so involved, and it's great to see everyone rally around their favorite team here at state.
Second and final timeout called by Holy Trinity Catholic. Let's go inside the Ankeny Christian huddle with head coach Michelle Quick.
Absolutely. We've got to think forward. Think forward. Think forward one point at a time. Let's keep communicating with each other on the court. Watch what number 17, when she's up there, when she's cutting those short angles, but keep swiping it right off of her, right? She can't get her hands on it, so keep swiping it right off of her. If you have to drop it right over the top, take it over the top. But you keep hitting hard out there. That's all we got to do. One at a time. Okay? Let's do it. Let's do it.
Here we go. All right, pressure. Keep it up. Eagles, eyes up.
Great advice from the head coach, and that you don't need to change much if you're in this position up 2-0 and you're sitting on a 6-point lead.
If it's working, don't change it. Keep the pressure on if you're Ankeny Christian. Keep that serving pressure on. Keep chasing down balls, giving that frustrating defense, and then having that vision to find openings on the court.
Miscommunication, strong serving again, Ankeny Christian. That's been their calling card. The kills are pretty equal, the blocks are pretty equal, the assists are pretty equal, but service aces has been the big difference. Still time to make a run if you're Holy Trinity Catholic. But the defense of Ankeny Christian is not, it's not a lot of openings that they're giving Holy Trinity to take advantage of. They've really sealed it up.
With their energy and excitement as well, just that extra bit of motivation to pick it up on the defensive end, and they're turning it into offense as well. So a lot of things going right for Ankeny Christian right now.
They defeated BCLUW in the semifinals, took care of Newell Fonda in the quarterfinals. A Holy Trinity Catholic defeated Don Bosco in the quarterfinals. And Boyden Hall, 3-0 yesterday in the semifinals. A double-digit advantage here in a must-win third set here for Holy Trinity Catholic. It starts with getting a side out ASAP, and it's not going to be on that play. And there's really not much that Holy Trinity Catholic can do, as both timeouts have been used. You could try some substitutions, but the locomotive continues to pick up steam as Ankeny Christian hits it into the net there. The champions that started at 10 a.m. today in 5A, it was Waukee Northwest over Dowling Catholic. A 12-15 start around there. It was North Scott defeating Indianola for the 4A title. Western Christian defeated Mount Vernon in four sets for the 3A title. Dyke New Hartford moved to 50 wins and no losses with the victory in 2A over Hinton. And now we're down to the final match of the high school volleyball season as Ankeny Christian is so close to taking care of business here and trying to win this in three straight sets. Craighead, Naring with 13 and 15 kills respectively for Ankeny Christian.
Holy Trinity seeing that one blocker up, trying to swing quickly, unfortunately, right into the net. They went on a few-point run there, strung together a couple right now with this large margin. Going to need to get it back quickly and go on a big run.
Ankeny Christian, the surprise, the 1A tournament a year ago. Can't get the point there on the pass. The door is left open narrowly here for Holy Trinity Catholic to put a run together. But little room for mistakes. Cruzy to serve. The freshman. And it's a doozy. That's a good, strong serve, right when her team needed it.
Good composure under pressure for the freshman. Set three late in the set, coming up with an ace. Nice job.
There's the pass. Here's the setter's dump. It sails deep and out of bounds. Two timeouts remaining for Ankeny Christian. Gonna try and see if her players can fight through this adversity, clinging to a 6-point advantage. Give and go. Perfect spot. And that brings up match point for Ankeny Christian. I like the way she plays the sport of volleyball.
With fire, with energy. She's not scared to attack anything.
Match point. They have the ball. She attacks, gets it blocked back. And it ends with a hitting air. 25-17 in three straight sets. Ankeny Christian, for the second year in a row, is your Class 1A state champion. Hugs on one side, tears on the other, as the high school volleyball season comes to an end in a dramatic 1A championship match. Stay with us, though, as we have all tournament team individual honors, the presentation of the runner-up and state championship trophies.
So much to be proud of, both of these teams accomplishing so much this year, making it to the state championship. Nothing to hang your head about here. Great play from both squads.
Balanced attack for Ankeny Christian. Strong back row defense, and serving really was probably the difference maker.
A lot of aces, tough serves, and if it wasn't an ace, they were getting Holy Trinity out of system. All around, great play from Ankeny Christian, back to back.
They're handing out the pink t-shirts that say state champions. Huge shout out to the Iowa PBS crew. Been working two full days here and love the opportunity we have to work with that outstanding team.
A fantastic crew, a great facility. The Iowa Girls High School Athletic Union puts on such a high caliber championship event in all of the sports, especially volleyball. It's very special here.
Ladies and gentlemen, your 2023 Class 1A All Tournament Team. From Ankeny Christian, Macy Nearing. From Holy Trinity Catholic, Tegan Snod. From BCLUW, Olivia Peters. From Newell Fonda, Kinsey Henders. From Ankeny Christian, Carly Craighead. From Holy Trinity Catholic, Mary Kate Benlagi. And the captain of the 2023 Class 1A All-Tournament Team, from Ankeny Christian, Katie Quick.
An outstanding team, Quick. Had herself a great championship match. One of the biggest reasons why her team claims that state championship. Quite an awesome individual honor for these young women, as both these teams that played at tonight's match, a combination of freshmen, sophomores, juniors, and seniors, and worked hard to bring the best out of each other and celebrate.
For the 1A championship match, presenting the award is Taylor Anderson of the Iowa Girls High School Athletic Union. This year's top producer of the 1A championship match, from Ankeny Christian, Macy Nearing.
We talked about, we like how she approaches the sport.
She's competitive, but she has fun. Look at that smile.
Introducing your last 1A runner-up, Holy Trinity and head coach, Melissa Priestmeyer. Ankeny Christian, it's time for you to complete the Class 1A bracket. Ladies and gentlemen, your 2023 Class 1A champions, Coach Michelle Quick and the Eagles from Ankeny Christian.
Kiss the trophy, you deserve it. For the second straight year, Ankeny Christian wins the Class 1A state title. Fun to watch. Last year, a surprise to many. This year, the bullseye, the target was on their back. It did not make a difference. They were able to finish the job and win the state title. It has been a long, fun-filled, entertaining day, but that's a wrap. The Iowa High School 2023 volleyball season is done. For the final time, your champions this year, 5A Waukee Northwest, 4A North Scott, 3A Western Christian, 2A Dyke New Hartford, and your 1A champion, we just witnessed it, Ankeny Christian. Beth, final thoughts on this special day.
A fantastic day of matches from start to finish. High quality, it was great.
This has been a production of Iowa PBS.
Funding provided by Musco Lighting, the sports lighting specialist. Providing lighting systems for you, your project, and your community.
The Pella Rolscreen Foundation is a proud supporter of Iowa PBS. Pella Windows and Doors strives to better our communities and build a better tomorrow.
And by Fareway Meat and Grocery. For more than 80 years, Fareway has been proud to be an active part of the communities we serve. Learn more at fareway.com.
With our Iowa roots and Midwestern values, Farmers Mutual Hale is committed to offering innovative farm insurance for America's farmers, just as we have for six generations. Farmers Mutual Hale, America's crop insurance company.